$24 million worth of security equipment rot in a warehouse. Not being used, just rotting in the warehouses. And today, lawmakers taking the TSA to task.
We're looking at both efficiency and effectiveness, and we find both lacking at the TSA.
5,700 pieces of equipment were sitting there. So I think this is outrageous.
Logistically, there were failures. Oversight, there was cover-up.
In a time when people are proposing even more extreme measures to address TSA's challenges, I see a very simple solution. Follow the protocols that have been established.
I wanted to know, where are the puffers? I went to Atlantic City and saw the puffers. They didn't work when I went through them. I had some trace on me, went through them multiple times, and they said it was just a software glitch and it would be resolved. Instead, they went forward buying puffers. This has been sitting there since December 12, 2010. Are you aware of this, sir? You're not aware of this. Well, somebody needs to get aware. This is hundreds of millions.
Congressman John Mica chairs the House Transportation Infrastructure Committee. He joins us. Congressman, frankly, I just don't know what to say. I mean, this is like night after night after night, and now this TSA.
Well, again, it's an outrage. And here we've been after them for the past year to find out where some of this equipment was. We had a whistleblower come forward and tell us that not only did they have a few hundred, but they had thousands of pieces of equipment sitting idle, some of it that could be used to detect the explosives and the kind of threats we've heard about just in the last 48 hours, sitting collecting dust in a warehouse in Texas.
Well, according to one report, 5,700 pieces of equipment are in that Texas thing, and it's worth $184 million just sitting there. And meanwhile, I think a lot of travelers, while they're very appreciative of what the TSA does to keep us safe, I tell you, the TSA, it could use a lot of improvement,
Greta, we told them we were sending our investigators down there when we got a tip that the equipment had been there for sometimes years, and they tried to put us off. They put us off for a week, so then we sent our investigators down there. Now, our investigators are going through the front door, and they're hauling equipment out the back door, and then they had the nerve to give us lists and documentation that was really falsified about what equipment was where.
Why don't we get our Justice Department on it and take a look to see if there's any criminal stuff? If they're trying to hide things and bring them out the back door, if they're committing fraudulent documents, certainly there's got to be something in there. There is stealing, there is fraud. Have you ever thought of giving a tip to the U.S. Attorney's Office, take a look at that?
Well, I think there may be some referrals here, but right now, terrorists are still targeting aviation, and when you've got equipment that is purchased and they let it sit there, or they buy equipment that we don't need, or they buy equipment that doesn't work and isn't vetted, and then you have an agency with no one in charge. The president didn't choose to put anyone in the position. They left TSA administration vacant for a year. This is an agency that cries out for reform.
Well, all this equipment is rotting in warehouses, and we're paying rent for these warehouses, right?
Not only rent for the warehouses, but the puffers, they paid DOD, the Department of Defense, $600 a piece to destroy after we got a tip that they were still sitting there for years and they're paying rent on them.
I know, but this sort of even the insanity, the fact that we're paying to store this equipment that we're not using, that we're ultimately going to destroy, that whatever, just to rot in warehouses.
Well,
yet last week you did a report with us, all this GSA empty space. At least we could use some of our existing empty space, not to go out and rent more warehouses to put this stuff in. I mean, the insanity just seems to roll on and on and on. It just doesn't stop.
Greta, what an incredible idea to actually store some of that in some of the vacant space we've seen. My goodness, this would never work in government. Obviously, it isn't working in government.
Does the president, the administration, say anything about this? I realize it's know, he's got a lot on his plate, but there's just so much waste and fraud and billions of dollars. We've got so much need for money in this country to solve real problems. What does the administration say about this?
Well, Mr. Pistol's in charge. We've given him a while. There was no one in charge before he was finally selected. And I think his time's about up because he's sitting on top of all of this and responsible for this. We have 14,000 administrative personnel and an agency that's grown to 65,000 people. There are 4,000 administrators just within a mile or so of the nation's capital for TSA, making on average $104,000 apiece. This agency cries out for reform. It's spending $8 billion, nearly that amount this year, and you see the waste in a Texas warehouse.
It might be cheaper just to buy every American a private jet than to, you know, so we don't have to have security. Everyone have its own. Anyway,
we're going to get it straightened out.
Well, you better move fast because it's pretty bleak. Congressman, thank you, sir.
Good to be with you. Thank you.
Coming up, Senator John McCain rips into Vice President Joe Biden.